मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू लेटेस्ट लर्न रिलेटेड सीरीज। दिस इज गुरु वेणुगोपाल फ्रॉम बनारस यूनिवर्सिटी। टिल टुडे वी हैव सीन हाउ टू क्रिएट डॉक्यूमेंट्स, हाउ टू इंक्लूड मैथमेटिक्स एटसेट्रा। इन दिस सेशन वी विल सी हाउ टू write the borrowed words, that is verbatim taking paragraphs from some other book, and also how to include various types of numbered lists and bulleted lists. Now start text studio. So what is the first command? This document class article we are writing, and then begin document and end document, and in the preamble we will write the title, okay, including list in LaTeX documents, okay, and author is so we don't want to date this like this. Now to bring the title here, we'll type set make title, okay. To save this, we generally save it a separate directory. Don't save your documents, okay. Here I am saving it. The extension will be tex. It will automatically give the tex extension, so don't bother about it. Tex, the name is LaTeX DocTeX. Okay, now when I compile this document, the title will come like this. Now we will see how to incorporate some paragraphs as it is verbatim. For that we use a environment called quote. This quote is used only if only one paragraph of material is to be included in your at that point, okay. Suppose whatever I am typing, it is not from any text or anything, whatever is coming to my mind I am typing here. I am just reading the book of like this, okay. So as a good practitioner step, what you have to do is whenever you complete some matter, just compile it so that if any errors comes immediately you can see. Otherwise what happens if you type 2-4 pages matter and compile it and any errors are there, it will be difficult for you to see what is the error you have done, what is the mistake you have done. Now you can say begin quote, okay, and end quote automatically comes because we are using the IDE integrated development environment called Tech Studio, and here I write something. It is not anything code, it is whatever to my mind came, I am writing here. Don't think it is said by Jawaharlal Nehru. Now when we compile it, you see it is left some place on the left hand side margin and right hand side margin, and also the letters are somewhat smaller than the main matter. Okay, now I will give here to see 12 point because it is typesetting in 10 point. Now you can see these letters are somewhat smaller than the main body letter. So if you have only one paragraph of matter to be quoted, you can use this. If you want to put quote marks, you just put the quote marks like this. You will get quote marks. Proper quote marks. And now like this. Now I want to quote two paragraphs. Okay, so for two paragraphs we generally use begin quotation and end quotation. Now we can typeset our quotations. So first paragraph I am typesetting. So this is the first paragraph of it. Okay, then to put the second paragraph, put two enters and types some more thing. Like this. When we compile it, we'll come. See, in single quote, begin, that means in begin quote, end quote, no indent was given to this paragraph and simply the matter was typeset. Whereas in this begin quotation and end quotation, a small indent is also given for each paragraph. So this is the way we have to typeset the quote and quotations, so it will beautifully leave space on both the sides without making any much effort. Okay, if it is in some other word processors, we have to properly select this and we have to give indents, tabs, etc., etc., and it will take some time. And here it is automatically done. Then, suppose you want to write some poetry in English. For that also, a small environment called verse is also there. Begin verse. To like this, and we will just say begin verse and end verse. Okay, the matter, whatever I am typing here, it is as it is taken from the book LaTeX tutorials. Okay, okay. So to come to the next line, we put two backslashes. Do you know why I am putting it? And another line. And another line. Like this. Now, when I compile this, your verse is typeset like this. Okay. So I used the backslash and double quotes to get this O with a two dots on it, Mobius. So this is the method to typeset a verse or paragraph and all this. Now we are going to next level, that is how to include various types of list. Suppose you have a list and there is no order for it, you are just randomly quoting the things in the list, then we use itemize, that is for bullets. Okay, begin itemize environment, and in it for everyone we are using it item. Remember the bib item in bibliography. Okay, same this was rewritten for the bibliography environment, and here it is simply item. Now this is the first one. Okay, then again item, this is the second one. Okay, then item, this is the third one, like this. So when I compile this, you will get a list like this with bullets. Okay, see the bullets here, and line, all these line spacing etc. is predefined. If you want to change it, you have to tweak some other things. Then in itemize, four levels were defined. This is the first level. Suppose in this first one, I have to give some other itemize again. Okay, then begin itemize, end itemize. This is the second level. Okay, item. This is the second level. Okay, item. This is the second level. Now when I compile, I get the second level like this with a dash, with a M dash. And third level, okay, I am again giving it begin itemize and itemize. This is the third level. Okay, item, this is the third level. Okay, item. This is the third level. Now they compile this. See, this is the first level, this is the second level, and this is the third level. Third level, it was automatically asterisks were given. Okay. Now there is another level is also there. So I will put another, the fourth level, fourth and final level here. Begin. Okay. Itemize item. This is fourth level item. So the fourth level is a small dot. Okay, a big dot here, a dash in the second level, a asterisk at the third level, and a small dot at the fourth level. So in this way, four levels you are divided: begin itemize and end itemize. But the thing is, many people may not like this. What is predefined? This big dot or dash, asterisk, and all this. So how to change this? We can change this. For this, I am using a package called PA font. Okay. To use a package, we generally put it after document class in the preamble. Okay. Use package PA font. It is a font package. It contains 256 various types of symbols defined with a name. Okay. Then I have to redefine the symbol. So to redefine it, what I say, backslash renew command. Renew command. We are changing the command. What is the command? The command's name is label item 1. Okay, label item 1. And the definition we are giving here, ding 42. So it is given with positions, ding 42nd position in the font table from 0 to 255. The 42nd place, whatever figure is there, it will come here. So now when I compile it, what happens? First, the package has to be installed. Okay, now I am telling install it. So it is installing the package. If you have installed all the packages at the time of installation of Protect, then there is no need to install all these packages one by one. Okay. To avoid, suppose you don't have much space on your hard disk, then you can choose this limited version and you can install whatever packages you need, because most of the packages are never used. You use mostly only 10% of the packages. So see, this ding 42 is here. Okay, this is the ding 42 symbol. Suppose you want to change all the four levels, then what we have to do? You have to redefine all the things. Renew command. For second level, the name will be label item 2, Roman 2. Then define it as ding. I am using the 43rd ding. Okay. Now when I compile it, This is the 42nd D. Okay. Then for the third level, I use renew command. Okay. Label item 3. Robin 3. Then here I am putting dig 44. Please give proper closings of the postage brackets, otherwise you will get errors. This is the ding 44. Then ding, I will again say it, renew command. Okay, label item 4, Roman 4. Then say ding 45. This is the third level, fourth level. So first level, second level, third level, fourth level, all four again. If I give this renew command in the preamble of the document, that is before begin document, the in the entire document the same thing will be applied to your document. Okay, but suppose you want to apply this only to a particular position, then what we have to do, you define wherever you want it and limit it to that area only. Here I am putting postage brackets, so I am limiting this. Again, if I use here, begin, itemize, okay. Like this, what happens? See, here I am getting again the same bullets. Okay, if you don't limit this, if you define it somewhere in between the document, if you don't limit it with any postage brackets, the same will continue onwards. See, here it is given, then again also it is there. So to distinguish it, I'll put something. See, this same thing is there. Suppose you want to change these things for this one, then you have to again change here the new command. Okay, here I am putting instead of 62, I am putting 72. See, let us see what is the symbol at 72. You see, at 72 it is a star, or 77. If I give 77, what comes? It is also a star, but there is a difference. See, it is outline. It is an outline. Then, suppose I put some 87. This is another type of star. These type of stars are there. So, this is the method to change the label items in itemize. After itemization, we will see, I will tell you, there is a document called the comprehensive LaTeX symbols document. It is I already given it the end. It is called as a4symbols.pdf. If you search for it, the comprehensive LaTeX symbol list by Scott Packin, you can see what are the various symbols, letters defined and available for LaTeX system. There are more than 14,000 characters, various types of characters are available. I will also show you in the end of this lecture the document, so you will appreciate it. Then now suppose you have ordered list. Yes, some sequence is there. For ordered lists, we use enumerate package, not package, enumerate environment. There is a package called enumerate also. I will tell you about it later. So this is for numbered list. Okay, so here also begin enumerate, and then this is the first one item, this is the second one item, this is the third one. Now when I compile it, I will get this type of numbered list, 1 2 3 4, like this. Here also in enumerate also there are four levels are defined. This is the first level, but to see second level, we'll say begin enumerate. Okay. And enumerate. In between, I'm putting item. Okay. This is second level item. This is second level. Now compile it. This is the second level. In second level, they have defined it as small ABCDs with parentheses. So because it is ABCD, there will be limit up to 26 only you can go. If it is more than 26, you have to redefine your thing. Then begin enumerate and enumerate. Okay, here the third level, I'm showing the third level. Okay, item, this is third level item, this is third level. Okay, the third level they have given Roman 1 2 3, small Roman 1 2 3. Then we will see the fourth level. Okay, begin enumerate item, this is fourth level. So in fourth level they give, it was defined as capital ABCD like this. So by combining this enumerate and itemize, you can get 8 levels. Here 4 levels and here 4 levels, you can combine both these also, then you will get 8 levels of itemization, all these things. Then how to, you don't like this 1 2 3 4, you want at this level capital A, here some other thing, then how to change this? For this there is a package called, already told you what is the package, the package's name is use package enumerate. If you use this enumerate package, now you can define as you like. Okay, begin enumerate, and here you can directly give the option. Suppose you want your enumerate, okay, first level, in parenthesis A. Okay, then this is the first one item, this is the second one, like this. So see, you will get like this. Suppose you want A1, A2, A3. So what you have to do, if I put A1 here and when I run this, what happens? This will become 11, 22, like this. So to get A and 1, you have to put A in most edge brackets. Then it will properly put your labels as A1, A2, like this. How do you like this? Like this, you can create anything. Suppose I want to write it here, step 1, 2, 3. So put, I just write step 1, okay, run it, and everywhere it will type step 1, step 2, step 3, step 4, like that. There is no need for you to always type the step thing. Now, in this section, there is another environment called description. With this, this is complete. Begin. Description. Then in this description, we'll give labels. Suppose I put it here, tech. There. Markup language like HTML. Okay, and here I put item label, I put a Linux is a operating system. Okay, like this. Now when I compile this, you will get like this. It is bold letters. Okay, all this will come. And if I type some blah 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 blah, what happens? You will just see. Okay, see, let's give it that this. So these are the environments that are available for the displayed lists, various types of lists, and your quoted text and all these things. I told you that I will show you a book. See, this is the symbol CF4. I downloaded it and put it in my computer, and whenever I give my this system, I generally give this document also to my students. Okay, this is the comprehensive LaTeX symbols list. This is by Scott Packin, and it was last compiled in 2017. I don't know whether there is any further thing is there or not. So there are more than 14,283 symbols are available, and each package's name, what is the package you have to use, all these things are given here. Suppose I will see it, semi-trans. Okay, semtrans, a transliteration symbol. See, all these are given here. This is it. Then you will get the appropriate transliteration symbol. Suppose you want to create some Sanskrit book, but types it in English with these type of symbols. Then you can use this. Semtrans transliteration symbols and create the document like that. See, WASI symbols is a package. Using this WASI symbols, you can get all these things like circle, octagon, right circle, like this. And in MN symbol package, these are the various symbols that are available, or suppose if you use add for package, you will get this type of leaves and all these things. Okay, see the name. And in Fourier package, you will get these type of symbols. Okay, then see PI font I have shown you. This PI font, these are the various types of stars from DING 65 to DING 107. Okay, these type of things. See, there is another package called BBDING. In this BBDING, every asterisk, everything was given by name. So you can use this also. So for that, you have to use package BBDING and renew command. And instead of DING search thing, you just write asterisk bold, a 5 star, a jack star bold, like this. So you will love to see this, see various types of knots, Celtic knots. Okay, I have never used these things. Even decorative borders, various decorative borders, and then UMRAND. There is a package called UMRAND. Using this, you can use many borders, etc., for your books and all these things. Okay, and this is Web of Mints. Package called Web of Mints. Using this, you can get all these things. And every symbol, whatever symbol is used nowadays, every symbol is defined in LaTeX. You will get every symbol. That is, even if you want to typeset a document with hieroglyphs that are used in Egyptian tombs, you will get a package that is also available. See, Facebook official, Facebook is where font awesome. First time I am saving. See, institution, everything. You will have more and more symbols are available like this. Okay, even see, looks like Indian flag, but it is not Indian flag, like this. Oh, flags are there here, miscellaneous BC logo. Okay, let us see that there is any Indian flag. No, France, Italy, all the things are there, but not Indian flag is not defined here. And just download this pack, document, and see various symbols that are available. Okay, these are the TIGS symbols, various oven rolling pin. See, both everything is available. These are the countries, various countries are there: Serbia, Portugal, okay, Bosnia, India is there. Recycles, various types of recycles. See here, staves, magical staves, various. And here, what I want to show you, Simpsons. Even Simpsons are also defined. These are available. Okay, you just by saying left and mark, you can rotate the symbol from this side to that side, like this. So the books I referred for creating this is, as usual, the tech user groups LaTeX tutorials primer, And the Scott Packins comprehensive LaTeX symbols, it is available at tech.org. And Peter Flynn's formatting information, these are the most important things. Thank you very much for patiently listening to me. This is Venugopal, and I will take leave. And in the next lecture, I will show you how to insert the graphics. Because in your thesis, you have to include many of your graphs you have created or photographs and all these things. And in that, I will show how to insert these graphics, so what are the packages that you have to use and all these things. Thank you very much for patiently listening to me. Thank you very much.